अशाच प्रकारचा दर्जेदार व्हिडिओ पाहण्यासाठी आमच्या चॅनलला सबस्क्राइब करा आणि नोटिफिकेशन मिळवण्यासाठी बेल बटनला प्रेस करा.
सो हियर द होल सब्जेक्ट इज डिवाइडेड इनटू टू पार्ट्स. द होल सब्जेक्ट इज डिवाइडेड इनटू टू पार्ट्स. हियर दे आर बिल्डिंग मटेरियल्स अँड बिल्डिंग कंस्ट्रक्शन. ओके, सो वी हॅव स्टडीड टू पार्ट्स इन द सब्जेक्ट. हियर दे आर building materials and building construction. And in the subject we have seen the topics, in the building materials we have seen the topics. We have started with the cement, then we have discussed the aggregate, concrete and admixtures, and mortar and bricks, stones, timber. And here in the lime, sorry, here in the mortar, we have also studied the lime. And in the bricks, we have also studied the brick masonry and stone masonry. Okay. And in the building construction, we have studied the building bylaws. Okay. Then we have studied principles of building planning. Okay. Then we have studied the foundations. Okay. And farm work. Doors, windows, and ventilators, and roofs, and stairs. Okay, so these are the topics we have discussed in the subject. Now, what's important in the material parts is, first you should know what are the properties of the material. Okay, you should know what are the properties of the material. When you want to know the properties of the material, you must do the testing. Okay, you must do the testing. Okay, so here you should remember what are the tests you have conducted, what is the apparatus you have used, okay, what is the apparatus you have used, and along with that, what should be the results? What should be the results? They are important here. Okay, suppose if you take the building material cement topic. Okay, if you take the building material cement topics, what are the tests we have conducted on the cement? We have conducted two types of tests. What are they? We have conducted two types of tests there. They are field test and laboratory test. Okay, and the laboratory test are again classified into two types, and here we don't need to worry about the field test. Okay, we can leave the field test. Even though you know you do not study, you can answer those questions on them. Okay, and here the laboratory tests are important, and the laboratory tests were again classified into two types: physical test and chemical test. Okay, so if you take the physical test here, again you have six kinds of test. In the physical test, again you have six kinds of tests. What are they? Okay, first one we started with the fineness. Then we have found the consistency. Okay, and then we have found the setting time test. Okay, then we have found the setting time. Then we have found the compressive strength. Then we have found the soundness. and then we have found the specific gravity. Okay, so here what you have to remember is, the first thing you need to remember is the apparatus we are using. Okay, suppose if it is a fineness test, what was the apparatus we are using there? 90 micron sieve, or else we have used the Blaine's apparatus. We have used the Blaine's apparatus. Okay, so here from this part, okay, from the testing of cement, at least one question will be coming. At least one question will be coming. Okay, and most of the times they will give the apparatus, and that apparatus is used to determine. Okay, so here for the consistency test, we have used the Vicat apparatus. Okay, and for the setting time also we have used the Vicat apparatus, and the compressive strength test we have used the 7.07 centimeter cube specimens. Okay, and for the soundness test we have used the Lee Chatelier apparatus or autoclave apparatus. Okay, and for the specific gravity we have used the Lee Chatelier flask. Okay, so here when you conduct the test, you are getting some results, right? You are getting some results there. So suppose if it is a fineness test and if you have used the 90 micron sieve, okay, if you used the 90 micron sieve, then for the OPC, this retained percentage should not be more than 10%. Okay, retained percentage should not be more than 10%. Okay, suppose if you have used the Blaine's apparatus, then it will give the result in terms of specific surface area, and for OPC it should not be less than 225 meter square per kg. Okay, suppose if you have used the Vicat apparatus, what it determines here? Water content. Okay, determines the water content, and this should be of generally 25 to 30%. Okay, then we have discussed about the setting time test, and what was the apparatus we have used? Vicat apparatus. Okay, and for the OPC, the initial setting time should not be less than 30 minutes, and final setting time should not be less than, should not be greater than 10 hours, and here it should not be less than 30 minutes. Okay, and then in the compressive strength test, we have determined the grade of the cement. Okay, we have determined the grade of the cement. And here, for 28 days, what should be the minimum compressive strength of the cement? 33 Newton per mm square. Okay, 33 Newton per mm square. Okay, and for 7 days, 22 Newton per mm square. For 3 days, 16 Newton per mm square. Okay, those values you have to remember. Okay, suppose if it is soundness test, if you have used the Lee Chatelier apparatus, then the expansion should not be more than 10 mm. Okay, and if you have used the autoclave apparatus, the expansion should not be more than 0.8%. Okay, and in the specific gravity test, we have used the Lee Chatelier flask, and what was the fluid we have used there? Kerosene. Okay, then what is the formula to determine the specific gravity? W2 minus W1 by W2 minus W1 minus W3 minus W4 into specific gravity of heroes. Okay, just if you write the points like this, okay, if you write the points like this, this can be completed within half page. Okay, but if you study everything there, it takes 3 to 4 pages of study. Okay, so whatever I have discussed, make a summary in the subject. Okay, that is very, very important here. Okay, if you keep on studying the notes or textbooks, I mean, every time you cannot repeat that. Okay, but if you write like this, even in 10 minutes, you can study all these things. Okay, so that is what required for the exam. Okay, and after studying this, you practice the previous questions from various exams. Okay, the exam might be the previous MPSC exams, the previous SSC JEE exams, previous IES objective questions, okay, and previous GATE questions. Okay, but if you take the GATE, this was a recently introduced subject, so there won't be so many number of questions. Okay, so better you study the SSC JEE previous questions, MPSC previous questions, and IES objective previous questions. Okay, so if you do all this, if you practice all these three things, then you can answer any question from the building materials. Okay, you can answer any question from the building materials, because most of the times the questions are repetitive. Whatever the question given in the MPSC exam 2015, that will be given in another state exam in 2016. Whatever the question given there, that will be given here in the next year. So like that it will be. Okay. So it matters how many questions you practice, because when you practice the questions, you will get the clarity on the subject. Okay. So if you want the clarity on the subject, you should practice as many as questions possible. Okay. And I have discussed the chemical composition of cement. Okay, I have discussed the chemical composition of cement, and what was the shortcut there? L psi mass. What does the L stands for there?
Lime.
Magnesia. Alkalis. Sulfur tracks. Okay, and I told another one. I love music sound. Okay, and that says that the unsoundness is caused by lime, magnesia and sulfur tracks. Okay, and for the brick composition, what was the shortcut? Salima. Okay, for the brick composition, the shortcut was salima. There, what is the major content is silica. Okay, and then alumina. Okay, and lime. Iron oxide and magnesia and alkalis. Which of them causes? Let me ask the question. So, which of them causes the color to the brick? Iron oxide. Whether it is the case of the cement or here, it will be caused by the iron oxide. Okay. And which of the compound causes the early strength to the cement? C3S or C2S?
C3S.
Okay. If you want to remember that, just remember that C3S particle is less in size and C2S particle is more in size. Okay. So here the particle size is more, so the hydration time is more. Okay. And here the particle size is less and the hydration time is less. Okay, so here you will get the early strength and here you will get the lateral strength. Okay, and if you want to remember the types of the cement, okay, if you want to remember the types of cement, I said that if the C3A is excess, then it will cause the sulfate attack as well as heat of hydration. Okay, if the C3A is excess, it will cause the sulfate attack as well as heat of hydration. Okay, now to resist the sulfate attack, which kind of cement you can use? Which kinds of cement you can use? Super sulfate cement, high alumina cement and sulfate resisting cement. In these three cements, the C3A content is less. So, you can use them for the sulfate resisting attack. Okay, you can use them for the sulfate resisting attack. That means you can use them for the marine structures. Okay, so wherever the C3A is less, that you can use for the marine structures. Okay, and if there is more C3S, the heat of hydration will be more, so you should not use it for the mass concrete structures. Okay, and if you take the low heat cement, I said that you can use it for the mass concrete structures because the heat of hydration is less. Okay, and how to manufacture the low heat Portland cement is by increasing the C2S and by decreasing the C3S and C3A. Okay, and why we have to decrease the C3S and C3A here? Because they produces more amount of heat of hydration. Okay, so in that way you have to remember the things. Okay, and which kind of cement you should not use for the hydraulic structures? Which kind of cement you should not use? The cement with high C3S and less C2S. Then which kind of cement we have to use is the cement with high C3S and less C2S. Is it right? No. The cement with high C2S and less C3S. Okay, for the hydraulic structures, the cement with high C2S and less C3S is preferable. Okay, so that kind of points are very, very important in the subject. Okay, and in the preparation of brick, which steps you have to avoid for the dry clay machine molding? Tempering and drying. Okay, how can you say that? Because you have not added any water there, so we need not conduct the tempering and we need not conduct the drying. Okay, so in that way you have to remember the things. Okay, so here what you have to focus mainly in the subject is what is the apparatus we are using. Okay, what is the apparatus we are using for the test, and then what standards the code is saying. Okay, what are the standards the code is saying, and what are the specifications for the test? Those things you must remember. Okay, and in the building construction part, you have to remember the dimensions mainly. Okay, you have to remember the dimensions mainly. They are very, very important there. Okay, and along with that, you have to remember the building bylaws. Okay, you have to remember the building bylaws as well as principles of building design. Okay, there are totally 11 principles in the building design, and there are totally 8 bylaws for the building. Okay, there are totally 8 bylaws for the building. Okay, and remember that all the bylaws were given by the NBC. Okay, it were given by the NBC, and what was the present existed NBC? NBC 2005. Okay, and when was the first NBC published? 1970. Okay, it was first published in the year 1970, and first time it was revised in 1983. Okay, so go in a systematic manner here and prepare the short notes. That is compulsory here. Prepare the short notes. Okay, and your short notes should not exceed 15 to 20 pages. Okay, and whatever the and what is the size of the notes what I have delivered? It's nearly more than 50 pages, right? It's more than 50 pages. But studying that 50 pages is not possible every time. So prepare your short notes for 15 to 20 pages. It should not exceed that. Okay? So when it is 15 to 20 pages short notes, you can revise that within one day. Okay? You can revise that within one day. So you should restrict it to 15 to 20 pages. Okay? So this... we'll close the subject, and thank you everyone. Thank you for your patience in the class.